Okay. Good afternoon, members of the Assembly. I'm Elizabeth Alexis, representing Californians Advocating Responsible Rail Design. I will note that we first asked for an honest assessment of the cost of this project more than 2 years ago, so we are very happy to see one. We will say, with that said, that this is the beginning of a conversation, not the end of one. The members of the Assembly will have a very difficult decision ahead of them. Do you fund this project, a project that is not yet ready, or do you say no? We think there needs to be a third alternative. This project needs another year to get to a place where you can make an honest assessment. You are being told, on one hand, that this is the only bite at the apple we will get, and on the other, that there will be enough support for another $55 to $75 billion of public funding. The truth must be somewhere in between. You are being asked to fund a project where you will have either committed to a $6 billion, incredibly visible white elephant, or to using every favor that you have in D.C. over the next 20 years on this project and this project alone. We'd like to see a truth somewhere in between those two. Transit experts are whispering in your ear that if this project could be just reimagined and rescued from the control of the consultants, it could cost half as much, give higher ridership, and cost less to operate. Is there validity to their criticism? We are starting to have some of the data that we need to put together a decent plan. We now have a cost estimate. We still don't have a new ridership model. The old ridership model from February 2007 has still been used to create these estimates, and we think it is highly flawed, so flawed that, yes, indeed, you might not even make these break-even numbers in the Central Valley. Right now, the current Amtrak service, which is actually quite good, yields about $20 million in revenue for the section, for the segments that high-speed rail would replicate. You have to get to at least $300 million by tripling the price of tickets to get to your break-even number. It's not obvious that this is going to happen. This is a very risky plan. You need another year to gather data. You need a new ridership model. My colleague will probably speak later about we also need an independent number. You need to have a real understanding of what is the cost of not doing this project. I think the LAO alluded to this. We don't have that number. You need to understand where the transportation needs are so dire that if you phase this so that you don't get to those parts of the state for another 20 or 30 years, they will have moved ahead with their high-speed, their highway projects, and you will have saved nothing. There is a lot of work to be done, and you know, I think we do want to, you know, thank the new board members for making sure that we have a real number on the project. But we did not expect that was going to be, you know, yes, it's good, but it's not a good number, right? I mean, the idea is we're supposed to sit down and rethink this project, and then once you have the best project that we can come up with, then it's reasonable to ask the Assembly and the Senate whether this is a project worth funding. I do want to touch on ridership once again, and just to, you know, I cannot stress this enough. I mean, we still do not have, you do not have an independent model, and you will absolutely need that. We are happy to sit down. I think the authority is talking now about having everybody sit down in a room, but I will note that this is the first time in over 2 years that this will have happened, and it's, you're not, they want to then be able to go out for bid in January. I mean, the time frames don't match up. So I urge you, figure out a way to get another year on this, because right now it's not something that works.
Okay, thank you. And the final